Today we are going to
tell you about pickled cucumbers. A pickled cucumber, commonly known as a pickle in the United States and Canada, and a gherkin in Britain, Ireland, Australia, South Africa, New Zealand, is a cucumber that has been pickled in brine, vinegar, or other solution and left to ferment for a period of time by either immersing the cucumbers in a solution or through souring by lacto-fermentation.
It is often claimed that pickled cucumbers were first developed for workers building the Great Wall of China, though another hypothesis is that they were first made in the Tigris Valley of Mesopotamia, using cucumbers brought originally from India.
Brine pickles are prepared using the traditional process of natural fermentation in a brine, which makes them grow sour. The brine concentration can vary between 20 to more than 40 grams of salt per liter, 3.2 to 6.4 ounce IMP gallon, or 2.7 to 5.3 ounces per U.S. gallon. There is no vinegar used in the brine of naturally fermented pickled cucumbers. The fermentation process is dependent on the lactobacillus bacteria that naturally occurs on the skin of growing cucumbers. These may be removed during packaging processes. Bacteria cultures can be reintroduced to the vegetable by adding already fermented foods such as yogurt or other milk products, pieces of sourdough bread, and of course, pickled vegetables such as sauerkraut.
A kosher dill pickle is not necessarily kosher in the sense that it has been prepared in accordance with Jewish dietary law. Rather, it is a pickle made in the traditional manner of Jewish New York City pickle makers, with generous addition of garlic and dill to a natural salt brine. In New York terminology, a full-soured kosher dill is one that has fully fermented, while a half-sour given a shorter stay in the brine is still crisp and bright green. Elsewhere, these pickles may sometimes be termed old and new dills. Dill pickles, not necessarily described as kosher, have been served in New York City since at least 1899.
Bread and butter pickles are marinated pickle produce with sliced cucumbers in a solution of vinegar, sugar, and spices, which may be processed either by canning or simply chilled as refrigerator pickles. The origin of the name and the spread of their popularity in the United States is attributed to Omar and Cora Fanning, a pair of Illinois cucumber farmers who started selling sweet and sour pickles in the 1920s and filed for the trademark Fanning's Bread and Butter Pickles in 1923. Though the recipe and similar ones are probably much older, the story attached to the name is that the Fannings survived through the rough years by making the pickles with their surplus of undersized cucumbers and bartering them with their grocer for staples such as bread and butter.
Like pickled vegetables such as sauerkraut, soured pickled cucumbers, technically a fruit, are low in calories. They also contain a moderate amount of vitamin K, specifically in the form of K1. 30-gram sour pickled cucumber offers 12 to 16 micrograms, or approximately 15 to 20% of the recommended daily allowance of vitamin K. It also offers 3 kilocalories, most of which come from carbohydrates. However, most sour pickled cucumbers are also high in sodium. One pickled cucumber can contain 350 to 500 milligrams, or 15 to 20% of the American recommended daily limit of 2,400 milligrams. Sweet pickled cucumbers also tend to contain significantly less sodium than sour pickles.
Making cucumber pickles can take up to 42 days, depending on the manufacturer's recipe. Production involves four primary steps, including harvesting, preservation, pasteurizing, and final processing. The process is highly automated once the cucumbers are delivered to the processing plant. Once harvested by the field workers, cucumbers are put in large bins and transported to a receiving station. If the cucumbers are transported a long distance, refrigerated trucks were used. This helps maintain the fresh appearance and flavor of the vegetable at the receiving station. They are poured out onto a conveyor where they are subjected to a cleaning process that removes the excess stems, blossoms, dirt, and other foreign matter. This step is important because trace amounts of bacteria on unwashed cucumber can ruin the final product.
Depending on the manufacturer, conversion of the cucumber into a pickle can be done in one of three ways, including fermentation, pasteurization, and refrigeration. The first and oldest method is a process known as fermentation. In this method, the cucumbers are transferred to a large, airtight fiberglass or stainless steel tanks. Some of these containers can hold over 40,000 pounds of cucumbers. The tanks are filled with a brine solution, which is made up of water and 10% salt. The manufacturer can take advantage of a naturally occurring bacteria that is present on the cucumbers or inoculates with a specifically desired bacteria. In either case, the bacteria are halophilic or salt tolerant. During the storage period of about 5 weeks, these bacteria break down the sugars present in the vegetable and produce carbon dioxide.
After the pickles have adequately fermented, the salt solution is drained. Pickles are immersed in water to remove all the salt they may have acquired. During the cure, from this point, the pickles are moved along a conveyor to a slicing machine, which cuts the pickles to the correct size depending on the type of product desired. They can be cut into slices, chips, or even be diced. Attempts are made to maintain as clean an environment as possible for the pickles, as contamination by microbes could result in an undesirable product.
After being cut, the pickles are typically placed in glass jars, although cans, plastic bottles, and pouches have also been used. The packing machines are designed to deliver the correct amount of vegetable to each jar.
The problem of spoilage is evident throughout the pickle making process. Cucumbers can spoil during the brining process, even during packaging, if they are exposed to air for too long. For this reason, pickles are pasteurized. In order to pasteurize the pickles, they are typically exposed to high temperatures for an extended period of time. Depending on how long the pickles are heated, pasteurization can either kill off the acidic tolerant organisms or inactivate all of the enzymes in the vegetable. In both cases, pasteurization increases the shelf life of pickles.
Both pickles are vacuum packed, which means the air is removed from the jar before it is sealed. This helps maintain the pickle taste and prevents contamination by microorganisms. In order to vacuum pack the pickles, air in the jar is replaced with steam just before the cap is sealed. When the steam cools and condenses, it creates a vacuum, reducing the amount of free oxygen present in the jar.
The jars are conveyed to a labeling machine. Labels are automatically affixed, and a freshness date is stamped on the jar. From here, the jars are removed to an automatic packing machine, which puts them in cardboard boxes. They are transported to pallets and shipped out to local retailers.
Thank you for watching
this episode of Adventurous Kids. Yeehaw!